I will sing to the Lord and make music unto him. I will sing to the Lord with joy. I will say, this is the day that the Lord has made, for he has made me glad.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, let us acknowledge our sins before our God, which are keeping us away from our own God. So let us feel sorry for our deeds, our words. And with a contrite heart, let us all together say, I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do.
Through my most grievous fault.
Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You may also put forth your intention before our God. Let us pray. Grant us, Lord, we pray, that being rightly conformed to the paschal mysteries, what we celebrate in joy may protect and save us with perpetual power. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. It seemed good to the apostles and the elders with the whole church to choose men from among them and send them to Antioch with Paul and Barnabas. They sent Judas, called Barsabbas, and Silas, leading men among the brethren with the following letter. The brethren, both the apostles and the elders, to the brethren who are of the Gentiles in Antioch, Syria, and Cilicia, greetings. Since we have heard that some persons from us have troubled you with words, unsettling your minds, although we gave them no instructions, it has seemed good to us in assembly to choose men and send them to you with our beloved Barnabas and Paul, men who have risked their lives for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ. We have therefore sent Judas and Silas, who themselves will tell you the same by word of mouth. For it has seemed good to the Holy Spirit and to us to lay upon you no greater burden than these necessary things, that you abstain from what has been sacrificed to idols, and from blood, and from what is strangled, and from unchastity. If you keep yourselves from these, you will do well. Farewell. So when they were sent off, they went down to Antioch, And having gathered the congregation together, they delivered the letter. And when they read it, they rejoiced at the exhortation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response for the psalm is, I will thank you, Lord, among the peoples. Please repeat.
I will thank you, Lord, among the peoples.
My heart is ready, O God. My heart is ready. I will sing your praise. Awake my soul. Awake lyre and harp. I will awake the dawn. Our response.
I will thank you, Lord, among the peoples.
I will thank you, Lord, among the peoples. Praise you among nations. For your love reaches to the heavens and your truth to the skies. O God, arise above the heavens. May your glory shine on earth. Our response.
I will thank you, Lord, among the peoples.
Kindly rise for the gospel.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Christ being raised from the dead will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
With you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends, if you do what I command you. No longer do I call you servants, for the servant does not know what his master is doing, but I have called you friends. For all that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should be abide. So that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give it to you. This I command you, to love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It is not surprising for all of us, but it is our journey being a human person that we must have friends. And if we look at our lives, maybe from the beginning, as we have entered our school time, and especially in 8th, 9th, 10th, and then later on 11th, 12th, the friendship becomes so important for all of us, isn't it? And now if you go back and see, friends were so many, especially like when the birthdays were there, when there were activities, and maybe when there were group activities, housewives activities, then there was some kind of competition, then friends were also there. This friendship has been developing in years and years. But as we go down the line, we somehow find all those friends are not to be seen now. They somehow disappeared or not there in the background at all. And then we realize, yes, friends are needed. But somewhere down the line, we have also started refining among those friends.
And then they will be our best friends, our friends who are like very close to us. But now also, if our friends are there, how much do we often meet? How much do we often talk? It's so busy timetable of our lives that we don't get time also to talk. I know one daughter, she warned her mother, saying, mind if you say anything to my friends, because it was during 10th, 11th, 12th, that time. And you see, that's how we are ready to do anything for our friends. If you can recollect, there will be many incidents in your life where you have gone out of your way, as if like savior of the world, and you have catered to the need of your friend. And it was so joyous moment for you. Today there are families who are living in friendship, and it's so beautiful to see them. Daughters, sons, and their parents, they are so united. And they are no more like parents and children, or father, mother, or wife and husband. But their level of relationship is to that of that friend. And they share everything. But does that happen in every family? That's a big question. Sometimes those friends who were so friendly enough, even the society was knowing, and if anyone could ask them, they could just pinpoint, yeah, they are friends and they will do anything. They somehow suddenly become the worst enemies of their lives. And what has turned them to be a most bitterful enemy of their lives? And that's what's so painful for our people to accept. How can this be? When I have been so much good to you, when I have been so much friendly with you, and our friendship was so much at the level of a different level where we could not even think of these things being happening. But it has happened now. That pain is so much in our hearts. It is difficult to let it out of our minds and our hearts. And what would be the reasons? Some petty reasons. There have been brothers who were so good friends, but when the dispute of the family properties came up, they had to be bitter friends, bitter enemies. Why? When there have been friends around in the society, suddenly they turn out so much worse enemies of their lives. And the greatest fault which they do is, whatever the secrets were shared between those best friends, when they become bitter enemies, they reveal them to the world. That's not fair. You were not friends because of that. Why is that it was so difficult to build a bond with your parents and to your daughters and sons and to be a friend? But friendship is still attractive. Our children will love friendships. And sometimes when they do not get friendship with their parents, they go out and they find it with someone else. That's what Jesus is telling all of us. And he's giving what should be the definition, or other, rather than not definition, what should follow up the friendship. And he says, there's no greater love than this, to lay down one's life for his friend. If you are a good friend, you must know to die for him. Jesus said this, but he did it practically. That's why the cross is always the proof of his friendship to us. He said, there is no greater love than to die for his friends. And he takes you and me as his friend. And that's why he will mention it clearly. I do not call you servants, because servants have been not told anything. But I call you my friends, because whatever I know from my Father, I have given it down to you. So you're no more slave. If you follow me, you're not a slave to me. You have been redeemed in this love of friendship. If this is the kind of friendship Jesus has shown to us, what is that makes us to destroy our friendships in this world. Property, ego, jealousy, doubt, rumors, to go around and to spread any kind of rumor, spoil the name. Maybe someone has ditched me in friendship, but maybe I am also one of the participants in that. To go and destroy other people's friendship, which I have no right at all. Because you are insecure maybe. You have no friends. My dear friends, sometimes even a status comes in, isn't it? Look, what was the status of our Lord? The status of our God Jesus was that He was God. Yet He chose to come down in this world. Not only chose to come in the form of human being, He chose to die on a cross. It was His humility. He could have said, I'm God. I don't want to die on the cross. I am your friend, but don't take me to that cross. But yet He did it. He went because that is His type of understanding what it means to be a friend. And that's why we need to die for a friend. Your friend can be your son, daughter, your mother, father, and any other person in the society. Whether it is Hindu, Muslim, Christian, anyone. Whether it is rich or poor. But this is the example which Jesus has shown us. Are we ready to die for our friend? So difficult, isn't it? And if that is not a commitment, then our friendship will be broken away by easily by anyone and by anything. Even things break up our friendship, isn't it? Money matters, house, car. Let us ask God's grace to give us that understanding that human persons are connected through relationships, not through things. And the relationships are higher than the things of the world. And Jesus has shown us that relationships are higher than the things of the world when He was given temptations in three different forms. Let us ask God's grace to really recollect our friends in our mind in today's Eucharistic celebration. And if we have strained our relationship, to pray for them today. And if at all we have courage enough to call up to them or to meet them and to say sorry and mend our friendship once again. Because it is not only that out of our own accord we are going to do, but it is because Jesus has shown us the way and He has mentioned, it is not you have chosen me, I have chosen you for this mission. Participate in this mission to go and to mend the relationship with your friends. Amen.
Lord,
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice of mine and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Graciously sanctify this gift, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed. An integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim,
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Philip Neri Ferrer, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us all together recite the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
With a smiling face, let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
This is the Lamb of God, the Lamb who have died on the cross and being a proof of our friendship. Happy are those who are called for his banquet.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
A new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you, that you love one another as I have loved you.
Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of the sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go to mend your friendship with your friends. Thanks be to God.
With trials and temptations, is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer.